Okay, folks, this is the Revolutionary War Cemetery. It's out in this really country. I don't know if this is called Jerome or Davidsonville. Stoystown sign says 8 miles from here. I know it's not Stoystown. So it's either, this is either Jerome or Davidsonville. I don't know where the county lines go, stops and ends. They don't really show that on when you're on the highway. So again, this is a Revolutionary War Veterans Cemetery. Sun is very bright, so let me get in the shade. Okay, so this is actually called, hold on, record that probably. Okay, this is called the Kine Cemetery Restored 2010. Okay, now let's go first. There's probably missing stones that were here. So we have stones here that obviously are not going to have any markings on them. Lost to history, folks. Actually, this has some initials on here. Yes, it does. Okay. This says, it looks like JK. Can't really read it because it's very old. I'll get to the bigger stones and to identify the Revolutionary War soldiers that are buried here in a minute. Now, okay, so here's something. Again, here is a homemade carved stone. If you see my other video of the Wingard Cemetery, Family Farm Cemetery, same thing. We found these hand-carved stones. This looks like a G. I can't tell what that is. Very old. Here's another one that this tree has either pushed over or just lost through time. Maybe it was moved and they didn't know where it went to. I don't know. So here's some. So this is a really old cemetery. I'm gonna try to find a date here in a second. So far, I haven't read any dates yet. This also has some kind of carvings on it. Looks like very old. Well, maybe not. It's hard to tell. It's really hard to tell. So here we go. Here's something. This is Kine, K-E-I-N. That's all I can read, really. The rest is gone almost. 1860 or 1808, I can't really tell, guys. So we'll find one with the, I know that there's a plaque here, I think too, that I can read. Again, hand carved, probably in a barn. I mean, you know, with hand chiseled, this is what they had. And I can't read the date either on this. So let's go here. All right, so this was redone. So Jacob Bluge erected the Queen Mahomey chapter, Johnstown, 1922. So probably it was just redone. Jacob Blow Sr. Sorry if I am not PA Militia, Revolutionary War, 1736-1810. So he survived the Revolutionary War. I hope you can read that. And I'm hoping I'm saying Blau or Blow. I can't pronounce it. Private PA Military, Revolutionary War, 1736-1810. So, and they have these little placards here, Revolutionary War. So, I don't know if he's the only, so there's several of these stones just stacked, you know, against this tree. So maybe this tree was very small when this cemetery was placed here. And you can kind of see there is, looks like there is some kind of stone. Maybe there was a stone wall, or this might have been some old foundation. I think it was probably an old stone wall because it continues. You can see it. Okay. So this is a, you know, very old cemetery. So in these days, sometimes that's all you got when you were buried, AGM, initials, JJM. Another JJM. And it looks like another JJM or JSM. I can't really tell. I see J and an M. And this one just says MM. All right, here's, this one says Mary at the top there. And two hands shaking. I don't know if you can see that, but it's two hands shaking. Wife of John J. Merle, died November the 9th, 1872, age 28 years old, 1 month and 20 days. And there's more writing in there. I think it's in remembrance, silence, slumber, rest in silent slumber or something like that. So this also, here's another one with also hands clasping together and shaking matter. So this might be like some kind of family, I don't know, emblem or something, I don't know. John Merrily died January 17th, 1893, age 88 years old, 6 months, 7 months, 6 days. Going home, I can't read it. J.J. Merrily died May 5th, 1886, age 34, years old, 10 months, 87 days. Again, more writing. This one looks much older. S.S. Miller, 33rd. I think he was a private in the Revolutionary War, because here is another placard. Gar, 1861, 1885. 1865, I'm sorry, excuse me. Here's John Merle. This one has a different crescent on it. Cross with a, through a crown. John Merle died May 5th, 1881, age 43 years old. This one's leaning over. I don't want to push on these folks because, I mean, this is the hand shaking again, the crescent. So this must be some kind of family crescent. Can't really read that. Can't read it. Here's one that's leaning over totally. Again, if you saw my other video, a lot of the slaves were given just a slab to mark the headstone itself and not nothing else. They didn't get a name, they didn't get a date, they didn't get anything. They just buried them and put a usually slate, because this is Pennsylvania and this is, was, slate is like everywhere around here. So this is what they would do. So every time I see any kind of stone slate just stuck in the ground like that, kind of tells me a good chance it was a slave's burial. But the ones with the carvings on, it's really the hand carvings. Obviously they didn't spend money on the tombstone, they just grabbed a piece of slate they had in the ground, they found, and they just hand carved it. I don't know if those are slave markers or not. I have no idea. I don't think so, because I've seen quite a few of these already, and something tells me it's not. See, here's also the two hands clasping. So I think this was a family crest for the Keims, K-E-I-M, if I'm saying it right, Keim. It might be Amish, because there's a lot of Amish out here. Actually, driving out here, I saw some Amish just working on a house, and they were wearing the Amish garb. So there is Amish out here. So the Keim really sounds Amish to me, because I kind of, you kind of get used to some of these words. And here's another one with the, I think I showed you this one already. Again, I can't really read this. There's, you can tell this is a much older one. 1868, it looks like. So let me see if I can get this in closer to you guys. Where'd it go? There it is, okay. 1863 or 68. It looks like an 8. You might not be seeing it, but I can see an 8. So this is really old cemetery here. And like I said, something tells me it's Amish, but hey, I could be wrong. It's not as small as I remember, because when I came out here the last time, I think what my mind put together was there's just a few Revolutionary War soldiers buried here, or a couple of them, and I think there's only like two or three. So anyway, so this is, again, probably another family plot. They were probably landowners. They probably had slaves out here, because it was that time when slavery was still in existence here. And like I said, this is a big open area here. I mean, this is you know, farmland, and they have this big lake out here, and there's a small river behind here, behind these trees. There's a piece of a bridge. I don't know if you can see it, somewhere right there. Anyway, there's a small creek that runs through here, and then it empties into a pretty big man-made lake. That's where I go camping and hiking and stuff out there. So, but this is definitely well cared for and taken care of. And I discovered this by accident. I've driven down this road many times to go camping and never paid attention. I just thought it was a small current family plot cemetery, and I wanted to be respectful. I didn't want to just, you know, jump in somebody's private cemetery, but it's not private. It's taken care of. It's open to the public. So then one day I just said, I got to see what's here, because I knew it was a cemetery, but from the road you can barely see that it's a cemetery. Just when you see this fence, that you can tell that it's a burial plot. Anyway, so then I popped in and checked it out, and I was surprised to see Revolutionary War soldiers buried here, which is really cool. Never found one that old. So this is some kind of old trail. You have a lot of kids out here that ride motorbikes and stuff like that. So I don't know what else is here. This might be an old well here from the farm. Never really walked around. I just discovered the cemetery and then never really walked around here. No, this is done. Looks like back in the 30s. It's probably some kind of reservoir. This is a filter for flooding, so if the flood waters get to this high, it can start to drain into here. So anyway, there's a marker trail here, so never been on this trail. Not planning on doing it today. But that's it. So imagine, go back almost 200 years or so, and what this place was like, you know? It's all horse and buggy. And there's a very big old tree right here. All horse and buggy, and you know, this was no man's land back in the day, you know? Just, you know, big farm or plantation or whatever. But yeah. But that's it. So I hope you enjoyed this video, people. And so this is my first Revolutionary War burial site. It's not a war site, so to speak. So this is just a family plot, and some of their family members were in the Revolutionary War, it looks like. But it wasn't, this isn't a Revolutionary War battleground or nothing like that. Okay, well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to make many more of these. Because there's a lot of these, I know where a lot of these hidden little cemeteries are. Real quick, there's another piece of slate. So this is in the ground, but I probably a head marker at one time, and it just fell down and kind of got buried. Okay, thanks a lot for watching my video, and hope you stay tuned for more. Thank you. Bye.